Good afternoon. Welcome on in to another episode of From Day One. Today we have a new Sov Cits moron in Wichita, Kansas, who thinks he's going to run foul of the cops. Let's find out.
That you're being recorded for my purposes and for your purposes if we need to go to court.
Okay, but you got no tag, so are you aware of that?
Is that your emergency?
It's not an emergency. You have to have a tag on your vehicle. If you're going to drive.
I'm sorry, what's your name and badge number?
Officer St. Vrain, ID 2509. This could go awesome, really easy, man, or this could go really difficult, okay?
I don't.
I prefer the really difficult.
I want to let you know that I am not driving. I'm traveling.
Oh, okay,
I'm not
so
using
you,
this
okay.
as
we're
a
not,
vehicle.
We're not going to go down this
route. This is a private automobile.
Okay, do you have ID on you?
What crime have I committed?
Being stupid in the first degree?
You don't have a tag on you. I'm not going to do this with you, man.
I'm sorry.
I've got other stuff that I could be doing.
An infraction is not a crime.
I don't care. I don't care what you're going to say. I need your identification.
Shut up.
Proof of insurance. You do not have a tag on your vehicle, so you need to provide that to me.
Right, so because this cop is not interested in any of his pseudo-legal woo, the Sov Cits asks for a supervisor because, as we all know, Sov Cits think supervisors possess the secret knowledge and will instantly tell their subordinates to back off.
I'm sorry, guys. Forgot to introduce I have along with us good old UK lovely boy, also known as Van Ballion. Van, go ahead and continue.
But he's in for a rude awakening.
That would be if I was driving in a commercial capacity. Can you please get your sergeant?
666, I got a fucking moron. Can you go in and start
the
moron?
No, that's not the case.
Yes, I have ID. You're not compliant.
I have ID, but it's not for commercial purposes.
I don't care what commercial, non-commercial purposes you have.
Well, I'm not following commercial law. I'm following common law, sir.
No, I'm not.
He's a
that's
fucking
not
moron.
On. Okay.
Black Law.
Just give me your ID.
Black Law Dictionary.
Okay, give me your ID.
Not a sovereign citizen, but quotes everything out of the Sovereign Citizen Handbook. So, you know the old saying, if it walks
like
a duck and quacks
like
a duck, then
it's a Sov Cits.
Yeah, it's a duck.
Black Law Dictionary. This is under duress, by the way.
What's under duress?
Being forced to.
His brain
without
cells.
Without my full consent.
You have a state ID from the state of Kansas.
No, I mean, I guess that is the state, or that is from Kansas State, not the state of Kansas, though.
What do you mean, from the state of Kansas?
From Kansas State instead of state of Kansas, meaning this is from the land and soil jurisdiction of common law and not the corporate jurisdiction. That is the state of Kansas.
Land and soil jurisdiction of common law. Well, that doesn't sound like something you randomly pulled out of your backside at all now, does it?
Yeah,
top
okay.
Tip, if you ever need this much word salad to explain your ID, then it's probably a fake and not worth the fiat currency you paid to a Sov Cits website.
Oh, I love
that. I must
that.
Admit,
that's
though,
rich.
That phrase would look awesome on a t-shirt.
Building 8, I'm right across from
insurance on your car? I assume not.
No.
Why not?
I'm not using it for commercial
what
purposes.
What happens if you run into somebody? How are you going to pay for that?
It's none of your business.
Oh, just curious. That's why
I don't
you have to have
questions.
Insurance. If you're traveling, commerce, non-commerce, any of that kind of stuff, and you run into somebody else, let's say somebody else is traveling, what are you going to do? What are you going to do?
I don't
answer
questions.
Okay. I didn't figure so.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, that's a great point, but it's one he cannot respond to, honestly. But it's probably the response you would get if this little scrot ever ran into you. Or he would just drive off and leave you and your insurance company to foot the bill, leaving to higher premiums the following year. So if you live in Wichita or even Kansas, be on the lookout for a guy who spends more time on his hair than he does on his filthy 15-year-old Honda Accord.
So do you have any other form of ID on you?
It's more like
I
a 25-year-old
Honda
Accord.
Social security number when you were born at a hospital. I have my two witness forms that go off of my birth certificate, but I'm not going to give that unless under duress.
What is your definition of under duress?
being coerced and forced to without my actual consent.
Yeah, good luck with telling the judge you were coerced into giving your ID, especially after admitting on camera that you don't have a license, registration, or insurance when the law requires you to have all three. Oh, and while you're in court, tell the judge you didn't consent as well, because we could all do with a good laugh.
Yeah, and I will find it if he does.
Are you trying to see if the vehicle is stolen?
Yes, but okay. You don't have a tag on it.
I can provide you with the title of it.
Okay,
hold on. And
what's making you think this title isn't real either?
Okay.
Let me guess, there's a notebook piece of paper that wrote the word title.
I'm sorry, do not touch my vehicle. Do not touch my automobile.
Please, touch it.
Oh, slipped up there. Now it's on the record that you called it a vehicle. That makes you subject to vehicle laws because that's exactly how laws work, right?
Yes.
Of course not. You'd have to be completely delusional to think calling your vehicle an automobile exempts it from regulation.
He's not delusional.
You're not allowed to search.
I'm not searching. I'm looking at
you
the
touched my vehicle. That is an unauthorized search.
Okay. No, I'm not searching. So
you just did. You leaned into the vehicle.
So now he's back to being a vehicle again and not an automobile. You know, when you can't even get your script straight, how do you expect anyone else to keep up or even understand it? Also, it's not a violation of the Fourth Amendment for someone, let alone a cop, to touch your vehicle while looking for the VIN. Also, if he wanted to, because you're being non-compliant, he could ask you to step out of your vehicle / automobile. Look up Pennsylvania versus Mims.
Yep.
Are you a sergeant?
He's right there if you got any questions.
Hi, what's your name and badge number?
My name is, you're an idiot,
these
badge
windows
number.
Don't roll down, I'm sorry.
Guess what? Yes, it does. Get the fuck out.
I'm not going to step out of my private automobile.
Oh, yes, you are.
And now he's back to being an automobile, with windows that may or may not roll down. Also, good luck with getting a soft sit to talk like an adult. I'm pretty sure hell will freeze over before that day comes.
Yes, it will.
I'm sorry, what's your name and badge number?
Sergeant Cooper, ID number 1882.
Sergeant Cooper, ID 1882?
That's right.
And what is this other gentleman?
69 Landon.
1669 Landon?
1869.
1869 Landon. Awesome, thank you, I appreciate that. Sorry, I wish not to contract with you guys.
I wish you to be stupid. Oh, wait.
I'm sorry, I wish to not contract with you guys.
I'm not asking you to contract
anything. Well, that's what a ticket is a proposition of contract.
No, it's not.
No.
Yes, it actually is. For commercial law, yes.
Commercial law pertains to businesses. The government is not a commercial business just because they are listed on a credit agency's website. And if a ticket or charge was an offer to contract, then nobody would ever be charged with a crime. It's just amazing to me how gullible some people are. Then again, whole communities of people believe the earth is flat, so
yes,
I shouldn't
they do,
really be that surprised.
Do not make me go back to those fuckers.
But you are forcing me to contract by giving me that ticket. When I've told you I do not wish to contract, and this is not a vehicle, I am not driving, this is a private automobile, I am traveling, and I am not conducting commerce on these roadways. It's not a game, this is law.
It's a game.
Once he's done, he will issue the citation and you can go about your business.
Okay. Which I hope you guys have the forms for rescission on it.
That's between you and the courts, I guess. I don't know what that means.
Every contract.
I don't care to be.
Okay.
I don't care to be talked to about.
Every contract has him being
it's
stupid.
It's not ideology, sir. It's law. It's not opinion. It is actual factual law.
No.
Oh, it absolutely is an ideology.
Thank you.
And the fact that this cop doesn't know what a rescission form is should be a giant red flag that one isn't required when issuing a traffic citation. Also, the fact that you're so passionate about this is kind of a red flag that you learned the law from someone who isn't a lawyer.
YouTube University.
So you're saying...
You're welcome to go to the court and fight this citation in court.
So you're saying that my rights are just able to be violated all the time here?
Please, yes.
I mean, that's obviously what you're doing. I'm wishing not to contract, and it is my right to wish or not whether I contract.
No, you ain't. Next question.
And I do not appreciate your officer touching my vehicle.
Oh,
touching my
automobile, I appreciate it.
Without consent when I was uncovering the VIN number up front.
No, you weren't. Liar.
Yes, and I was providing him the VIN number and the title to prove that it was not stolen and it is under my ownership.
Again, liar.
Oh, bless him. He's still upset about the police officer opening his car door. Wait until he finds out about Pennsylvania versus Mims. That's really going to freak him out.
Yeah. It will.
Well, I've been traveling for...
Ever?
A little over half a month now. Haven't been pulled over. I'm just waiting until I get... I'm waiting to get private traveler's plates that are non-UCC or for non-commercial purposes that tell you and show and prove to you guys that I am not conducting in commercial capacity when you see
me. Ooh, can I slap him, please?
To stop me and figure all this out right now.
First of all, those private tags are a con. They never work. But they do one good thing. They are a massive advertisement to law enforcement that you're driving illegally. So expect an increase in traffic stops when you put them on. And don't forget to record every encounter. And secondly, the only thing these cops figured out is how dumb you are to fall for an ideology that, if true, would make all law enforcement redundant.
And the oxymoron your officer used as a sovereign citizen, it doesn't mean anything. Sovereign, if you look up Black's Law definition of what a sovereign is and then what a citizen is, they are two different things. I am not a citizen.
You're right, you're a moron.
Just letting you know that.
You're right, he's a moron, Your Honor. More.
Okay.
Well, if you have a problem with the term sovereign citizen, take it up with the creators of it, the posse comitatus, the original Sov Cits, because they coined the term. And just because something is an oxymoron doesn't mean it cannot exist. Jumbo Shrimp is the perfect example.
Mm,
also, you don't have to be a citizen to be subject to a country's laws. Just ask people like Courtney Love, Paul McCartney, Snoop Dogg, Ozzy Osbourne, Axl Rose, Hugh Grant, Keith Richards, Boy George, the list goes on. So if what you're saying were true, then I think their lawyers would have found that loophole.
And can you tell me why he's running code for a non-emergency? He also blipped his sirens, which sirens are fine, but the actual code for a non-emergency? Red and blue flashing lights for non-emergency, whereas he sounded his siren. The siren? He used a siren.
Yeah, he's supposed to.
Yeah, that's fine. But the blue lights, the blue and red lights for non-emergencies? I'm sorry, you're committing fraud and violations every day then.
Yeah, no, they're not.
If you are using the siren at the same time.
Says the guy driving without a license, registration, and insurance.
Right.
And yeah, that sigh the cop made is pretty much the same sound my wife hears every time I find another right to travel fail video. So about 2 to 3 times a week on average. Seriously though, in what alternate reality is a cop using his lights and sirens, or his sirens but not lights, for the intended purposes against the law?
Might check your front left tire sometime. Let's blow low.
I know. Nope. Thank you, though. I appreciate it. Yeah.
No, you don't.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm not using it for commercial purposes, and I wish not to answer questions about anything else.
You answered three stupid, Your Honor.
Officer? Sergeant?
Loser? Oh, sorry, that's you.
Officer, I do have here a fee schedule of which, if you guys wish to provide me a proposal of contract in the form of a citation of a ticket, I would need you guys to read this and be aware of what you are trying to have me contract to before I contract to it. Okay?
There's a piece of paper. Let's throw the paper.
Okay. I have here a fee schedule.
What?
An intent of fee schedule for...
That's an intent of him being...
Basically, if you guys wish to contract with me, you have to abide by my provisions of contract as well, which I was...
I don't know what you mean by contract. I think I could
Well, I have to let you guys know, as you guys are the ones issuing the contract to me in the form of a citation ticket. Which... So, are you accepting and refusing to see these?
I'm not accepting anything.
So, you're refusing to see these?
Yeah, I'm refusing to see them.
Okay, then...
I would like to see your insurance, though.
Now, that was pretty much the perfect response to all that word salad, because here in the real world, not having insurance has real-world consequences. Also, that fee schedule is a waste of perfectly good paper.
Yeah, we can
I would only need insurance if I was operating in a commercial capacity.
Wrong!
That is the law.
No! No, it's not.
Yeah?
No. It is.
This isn't a vehicle. This is a private automobile.
It is
the vehicle
his
is a
whistle.
Commercial term.
It is his nuclear
I am
whistle.
I'm non-commercial.
He likes his
That was from prior.
He likes
Which
his nuclear
I'm
whistles.
Not conducting any commerce right now.
Yes, he is.
No.
He's conducting
no, not
stupidity.
Anymore. I stopped that the 30th of April. I don't answer questions for prior incidents.
Would you like to answer going to jail?
So the officer's going to come up and he's going to issue a citation. You don't have to sign it. That's fine.
Please don't. Because then we'll
go in. You'll put it in your car through the window and you can go on about your business. You'll have 10 days to take care of that citation. Okay? By receiving that, it's not a measure of guilt. Just that you receive a copy of it. All right? There'll be a number circled on the bottom.
Not from you. As long as he's the one providing the issuance of the contract, then they mean nothing to you, even though they are a contract.
Yeah, I'm not abiding by any contract.
So, if you aren't abiding by any contract that I am providing you in return of the contract you are providing me, then does that not mean that you are?
I said how to go about that. It's taking the court and see the judge.
No, right, so the cop is back with his citations and hopefully with a tow truck on route to impound the vehicle for no insurance.
Hi. Alright, Mr. Dubas. Okay, I'm citing you.
And there's the fake American state national ID card with his real name, real address and real date of birth, and of course the signature thumbprint in red ink, which he freely handed over to the cop, by the way, so by his own logic, contracting with this cop. That's a shame. With the rewards from that sweet fee schedule, he could have shown his 15-year-old Honda Accord the love it so desperately needs.
Can I have the cover for this, the envelope?
Of course.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
All right, I got a citation here for you. Warrants?
No.
You're not?
No.
Where are you at?
Care of?
You want to give me a phone number?
Do I have to provide
you
that?
You do not.
Okay, then no.
Okay, so I'm citing you for no DL, not having your vehicle registered, and knowingly driving with no insurance, okay?
Okay.
You understand that?
I comprehend it. I don't stand under it. Yeah.
Oh, the word understand is synonymous with comprehend. So you're basically telling this cop you understand him. And that word salad about not standing under it means diddly squat.
Yes.
You want to sign this saying that I just gave this to you, not admitting guilt?
Yeah. I will sign that.
Put it upside down, sign it for me, please.
Where at? Okay.
Where it says signature of moron. AKA you.
Is this the vehicle you were in the hit and run with when you got hit?
Correct.
Who'd you call when that happened?
Ghostbusters.
I don't answer questions other than what I want to.
Throw other shit up.
So I was hoping you got that taken care of and they found the run vehicle.
Not that I know of.
Yeah, I bet it's really annoying to be involved in a hit and run, especially if that driver was uninsured and couldn't pay for the damage to your car, so ran. But I see you contracted with the police by making a police report. Funny how you use the police when it's to your benefit.
Correct.
You've got 10 days to take care of this, you understand that?
Oh, perfect.
Sure. That's actually my autograph.
That's an autograph?
Correct, as the living soul.
Living soul. As a living loser.
Yep, not a agent of the state under color of law as you guys are acting.
Yeah.
Which, do you have a liability insurance number? Or a bond policy number?
I do not.
Oh, so you're saying
right,
that...
Hey, right back here, where I put in parentheses, that's where you need to call or take care of this, okay?
Awesome,
my boss has explained it to you. So you got 10 days, okay?
Awesome, appreciate that.
All right, Anthony. So I'm going to tell you, don't drive. You don't have a license. No,
I'm not driving.
It's not, hey, I don't want you traveling on any of the streets out here that we consider public roadways, okay?
You cannot control my right to travel.
All righty.
Great.
Thank you. You guys have a wonderful day. Thank you. You too.
So after being warned not to move his vehicle, he waits for the police to leave and cuts the video. I'm guessing he gave it a few minutes before driving away. And why they left without towing his car, knowing he wasn't insured and knowing he doesn't respect the law, is irresponsible. So again, if you live in the city of Wichita or even Kansas, beware of a silver 2007-ish model Honda Accord, because he doesn't have insurance and by the state of the car, no way to pay for any damage he does to you or your vehicle. Right, thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, then please leave me a like.
Thank you very much. We definitely appreciate you. And with that, we will bring the afternoon to a close. Come on back tonight for more fun, more soft sits, and more morons here from day one. Have a great afternoon again. We'll see you.